Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video you will learn how to solve LPP problems by simplex method. I have already made one detailed video on simplex method. I strongly recommend you to watch that video. The video link is provided in the description box. So in this problem, the problem is given like z max is equal to x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 and these are the constraints. 2x1 plus x2 minus x3 is less than or equal to 2. Like this way, they are given the three constraint. So the first step in the simplex method is convert this problem into a standard form. What standard form says is our objective function should be always z max, since the problem is given already in the z max, that is a maximized function. So no need to convert this. So let us convert this constraint into an equation. So in the previous video, I have already shown you how to convert this. So let me show it one more time. So 2x1, I'll take the first constraint. This is the first constraint. So 2x1 plus x2 minus x3 is less than or equal to 2 is there. So whenever we have a inequality sign as a less than or equal to, what we need to do is we need to add plus s1 for this and make it as an equation that is equal to 2. Now I'll take the second constraint. So in the second constraint, what you can find here is we have, after the inequality sign, we have a minus sign. So this is called as a RHS sign, and this RHS is coming with a minus sign. So what standard forms is this? We should not have a negative on the RHS. So in order to make it positive, what I'll do is I'll multiply this second constraint by minus 1. So this second constraint I'll be multiplying with a minus 1. So when I multiply with the minus 1, what I'll get is I'm going to write it here. So minus x1 will become plus x1, plus x2 will become minus x2. So all the sign are going to convert, and this is greater than or equal to sign. When I multiply with the minus 1, so this inequality will get to be converted into less than or equal to, that is minus 6 we have, so that will become, that is plus 6. And then what we have is, again we have a less than or equal to sign. So again I had to make it into equation. So what I'm going to write it is x1 minus x2 plus x3. So we have a less than or equal to sign. So whenever we have a less than or equal to sign, what we need to do is we have to add here. So already s1 is taken, so I'm going to take here s2 and I'll make it as an equation that is equal to 6. Now these are with the two equations. Now I'll take the third constraint. Then the third constraint, so 4x1 plus x2 plus x3, we have a less than or equal to sign as the inequality sign. So what we have to do is, whenever we have a less than or equal to sign, again we have to add it here. So I'm going to write it the third constraint in the standard form. 4x1 plus x2 plus x3 is less than or equal to, we have sign here, so we have to add here plus. So already s1, s2 is taken, so I'm going to take here s3 and I'll make it as an equation that is equal to 6 here. So my standard constraints are, so this is the first constraint and this is the second constraint and this is the third constraint. So, okay, now after converting the constraint into an standard form, now what we need to do is we have to construct a table like this. Now in this table, what we have is we have a basic variables CBO. And these are my all the variables, so x1, x2, s3, x3, s1, s2 and s3. So since we have three slack variables, so take down that slack variables here, and we have a RHS and last one is a ratio. Now let me explain this first. Now what is this basic variable is? So this is the first iteration that you are doing it. Always your first iteration, for the first iteration, always you have to take a slack variables. So in this problem, we have a three slack variables, s1, s2 and s3. So I'll be writing these variables s1, s2 and s3 for the first iteration. Next I'll move to this one. Here what we have is, we have a CO, that is a coefficient of objective function. Now in the problem, my objective function is x1 plus 2x2 plus x3. So since we don't have a s1, so what I'll do is 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3, I like it. So nothing I have changed it here, only I have multiplied with a 0, so it will remain the same. Now what we need to do is we have to write the coefficients of these variables, since in this we have to only write the coefficients. So coefficients are nothing but the only the values. So x1 coefficient we have to write it here, x2 coefficient here, x3 coefficient here, like this we have to fill this. So if I go into the problem, so I have x1, the x1 coefficient is nothing is there, so that will be meaning that is 1 will be there. So x2 coefficient is 2, x3 coefficient is 1, s1 coefficient is 0, s2 coefficient is 0 and s3 coefficient is 0. So that I am going to fill it here. So that is 1, 2, 1, 0, 0 and 0. So once you write down this, later on what we need to do is we have to write this CBO. So what is the meaning of this is the coefficient of basic variable in the objective function. So what I meant to say is the value of S1 in the objective function. So value of S1 in the objective function is 0. So that I am going to write here. The value of S2 in objective function is 0. So similarly the value of S3 on the objective function is 0. So this is the beginning stage. Next, what you need to do is you have to write the first constraint in the first row, second constraint in the second row, third constraint in the third row. Only you have to write the coefficients here. So since this is the first constraint and the x1 coefficient is 2, x2 coefficient is 1, x3 coefficient is minus 1, s1 coefficient is 1 and this is called as RHS set and that is equal to 2. So I'll be filling directly these all the three constraints in this form. This is the first constraint and next constraint is we have 1, minus 1, 5, there is no any S1 here, so 0 will come, S2 value is 1, S3 is not there, so 0 and that is last one is 6. And last third constraint on the third row, so 4, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 6. So now I have converted all the three constraint in the three rows. Okay, now after completing this table, the next step is you have to calculate the entering column variable and leaving row variable. To calculate the entering column variable, we have to calculate the Z equation, and to understand or to calculate the leaving row variable, we have to calculate the ratio. So let me first explain you how to calculate this Z equation. So for to calculate this, we have a formula like summation of CBO into XI minus CO. So this formula you're going to use it to calculate Z equation. Now what is the meaning of this is, this is a multiplication, that is CBO into XI is a multiplication and the summation. So we have to add this minus of CO. So let me explain with an example here. Now in this, what we have is CBO is this and XI is this, fine. So we have to multiply this 0 into 2, we have to multiply it. Next summation we have, so shift it to next row, 0 into 1, next 0 into 4. So 0 into 2 is a first row and then we have a summation plus then next what we have is 0 into 1 we have, so 0 into 1 we have. Next what we have is 0 into 4 we have, so plus 0 into 4. So now this portion is done. Now next what we have is minus of CO we have. So for this column the CO value is how much? It is 1. So that value I'm going to substitute here. So when I calculate this, I'll get answer as minus 1. So that minus 1 I'm going to write it for this. So for this column my Z equation is minus 1. Like this way you have to use the same formula which I have told it for this one, and I directly want to substitute this. So for this I'll get a minus 2, for this I'll get a minus 1 and for this I'll get it a 0 0. Now what we have to do is after this is, now among this Z equation we have to select the maximum or highest negative value. Now here I have got a Z equation values as minus 1, minus 2 and minus 1. So among this I have got a minus 2 as a highest negative value. So I'll be marking this column as my entering column, and my entering column variable for this column, my entering column variable is, that is x2. You please mark this. Now we'll calculate the leaving row variable. So this leaving row will be dependent on the calculation of ratio. Now the formula which I am going to use it for the ratio is, that is RHS divided by the entering column coefficients. So these are my entering column and these are the coefficients. Now what is the formula? I have said it, ratio is equal to RHS divided by this, that is 2 divided by this. So I'll get a 2, and here RHS divided by this, the entering column is minus 1. So I'll get, of course, here minus 6. Next, here what we have is 6 divided by 1. So that is 6. Now among this, we have to select the least positive value. Here I got a 2. Here I got a minus 6. So minus will be not be considered. Only we have to consider the positive values. Here I have got a 2 and here I got a 6. So among this, the least positive value is 2. So this is my leaving row. So that leaving row, I am going to mark it here. So the leaving row variable is S1 and entering column variable is X2. So in the first iteration, what I found it is the entering column variable, that is X2, is going to replace this S1. Now we'll move ahead with the second iteration. So in order to start with the second iteration, so first we should take care about the basic variables. So in the first iteration, what I found is this X2 is going to replace this S1, and this S1 is in the first row. So what I'm going to write is, so in place of this S1, I'm going to write this X2. So X2, I'm going to write it as it is, and this S2 and S3 is not at all affected. So I'm going to write it as it is this. Okay, now after writing this, you have to write the coefficient values of this. So for this, you have to use the same method which I have told it for the first iteration. So you have to check the value of this x2 in the objective function. So x2 value in the objective function, it is 2. So that value I am going to write it here. And then this value of s2 is 0 and value of s3 is 0. So I will be writing the same values here. Now I am going to write first for this. I am going to write the coefficient of this first. So why I am writing for this is, since there is an intersection of entering column and leaving row for this only, and this is one is called as a key element. Now for this S2, how to write here is, we have to divide this whole elements by this key element. So what I am trying to tell here is, this 2 will be divided by this key element. So when I divide 2 by 1 is, I'll get 2. 1 divided by 1 is 1, minus 1 divided by 1 is minus 1, 1, 0, 0, and this is 2. So this completes your the coefficients of x2. So this is called as a new pivoted equation elements. Now I'll tell you how to write the coefficient of s2 and s3. Okay, now we will going to write it for s2. Okay, now to write this, I have made a simple technique for you people. So what is the technique here is, first you have to write old elements of S2, means you have to write the coefficients of S2 from the previous iteration, minus non-pivoted equation element, that is from the present iteration you got these values, these are my coefficients, into the coefficient of entering column. So what I meant to say here is, first I am going to write it the old elements of S2. So old elements of S2 is nothing but what? From the previous iteration. So previous iteration is, this is a previous iteration, and these are the values. So those values I'm going to write it here. That is 1, minus 1, 5, 0, 1, 0, and 6. These are my previous iteration values here. And next one, what we have is, we have a minus minus, so note down that minus. Then into the bracket we have like non-pivoted equation element into the coefficient of entering column. So non-pivoted equation element is already calculated from the present iteration. So these are my values. So those values I am going to copy it here. That is, the values are 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 0, 0, and 2. And next what we have is, we have a multiplication. So write a multiplication to this all the values. Now this is important. Now the coefficient of entering column. So for what we are writing here? For S2 we are writing it. Now we have to go and check what is the coefficient of S2 in that entering column. So for that, what we need to do is, so go to the table. So check in the first iteration, the value of S2 in the entering column. So this is my entering column. the value of S2 is minus 1. So this is my entering column coefficient for S2. So that minus 1, that is a minus 1, you go to write it over here. So for all this, we have to write minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Like this way, you have to complete this. Now do the operation here and write it the values over here. So after doing this operations, I'll get these my values. So these are the values for S2. So in the second iteration, you note down these values in this row. That is, so S2 we have done it. So note down the all the values for S2 over here. So 3, 0, 4, 1, 0 and 8. So these are my S2 value. Now you have to do the similar method to calculate the S3. The formula will remain same. Now only change are what? Here this is S3. So what we need to do is, it's in the same here. So here you write the S3. So here will come S3. And note down the, all the old elements of S3 over here. This is going to remain same. New pivoted equation element will remain the same. So this will remain same. Now here the coefficient of entering column. So for this what we need to do here is, so we are writing for S3. So in the first iteration, this is my entering column. So we have to check the coefficient of S3 in the entering column. So S3 coefficient in the entering column is how much? That is 1. So here you write 1 here, not minus 1. So minus 1 is for S2 and for S3 you will get a 1. So after doing this calculation, so I will be directly writing these values over here. So I get a values like 2, 0, 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 4. So I have completed the coefficients of S2 and S3 now. Now after doing this, again the method will remain same. First you have to calculate which is my entering column variable and leaving row variable. So to calculate the entering variable, so we have to calculate the Z equation. And the Z equation calculation will remain same as that you have followed for the first iteration. Formula will be same. So what we need to do is, we have to multiply this into this, this into this, this into this, and we have to add these values and then minus of CO. So formula will remain same which I have used for calculation of Z equation. So instead of wasting a time, I'll be writing the direct values over here. 3, 0, minus 3, 2, 0 and 0. So these are my Z values here. So now again you have got a negative value. So that means that there will be one more iteration. So you have to continue this iteration till you get all Z equation values are positive. So among this, which is the highest negative value? So this is my highest negative value. So that column, I am going to note it down. The next thing that you need to do is, so for this entering column, the variable is X3. So X3 is going to, now it's going to come in this place. Now next step is, we have to calculate which is my leaving row. So leaving row will be selected based on the ratio. So the ratio formula will be same, that is RHS divided by this entering column coefficient, that is 2 divided by minus 1. So 2 divided by minus 1, I'll get it minus 2. And then we have 8 divided by 4, we have 8 divided by 4 is 2. Then 4 divided by 2, that is 4 divided by 2 is, that is 2 it is. So now I have here minus is there, so neglect the minus. Now what we have is, here also 2 is there and here also 2 is there. So in this case is, what we can do is, we can choose any of these. So what I'll do is, I'll be selecting this now. I'll be selecting this and the as my leaving row, and the leaving row variable is, that is S2. So entering column variable is X3 and my leaving row variable will be S2. So my S2 will be replaced by this X3. So we will go for, that is the third iteration now. So moving ahead with the third iteration. So for the third iteration, see this X2 is not at all affected. So that I'll be writing as it is. Now affected row is this S2. Now in place of this S2, which will come? That is this entering column variable is X3. So that X3 I'm going to write it here. Next, what we have is, this S3 is not at all affected. So that I'm going to copy it as it is. Now in the third iteration, since this is affected, first that is this one, so this will become my non-pivoted equation element, so that I am going to write it first. Now to write this, the method will remain same that you had followed for the second iteration. First thing is that you note down the key element. So this is my key element, that is 4. Now what we need to do is this 4 will be divided for all this. And before doing this, first we will write the values of this x2, x3 and s3 from the objective function. The value of x2 from the objective function is how much? That is 2 we have, and the value of x3 is 1 and the value of s3 is 0. So that value I am going to write it over here. That is 2, 1 and 0. So this value I am going to write it. And the next method is, since what I have told is to write this x3, we have to divide this whole row by this key element, that is 3 by 4, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 and 8 by 4. So that value I am going to write it here. 3 by 4, 0 by 4 is 0, 4 by 4 is 1, that is 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 0 by 4 is 0 again, 8 by 4 is 2. So this is what I have written for x3, and this will become my new pivoted equation elements. And the calculation for this x2 and s3, which I have already discussed over here. So we have to write the x2 here. So what we need to do is, so since we are writing for x2, so first you note down the old elements of x2. So old elements of x2 here, then minus we have, then next new pivoted equation element from the present iteration. So we are doing the third iteration here. So in the third iteration, whatever the new pivoted equation elements are, that we have to copy it. Next, that will be multiplied by this entering column coefficient. So that we have to write it here. Now I'll show it one example over here. So first you write down the old elements of x2. So what is the meaning of this is, so in the from the previous iteration, the old elements of x2 we have to write it. So these are my x2 value over here. So these are my values. So we are doing third iteration. So my previous iteration are nothing but this. So these all values I am going to write it over here. That is 2, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 0, 0 and 2. So these are my old elements. So minus, 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 minus. We have a minus here. So that is a minus. And into the bracket, what we have is new pivoted equation elements. So this are nothing but what? From the present iteration. So here, which I have calculated right now. So these are my new pivoted equation element. So those value I'm going to write it over here. That is 3 by 4, 0, 1, 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 0 and 2. So these are my new pivoted equation elements. And next what we have operation here is multiplication. So multiplication. So I'm going to multiply. Multiply what? This is entering column coefficient here. So I'm going to write it for x2. Now what we need to do is, so from the last iteration, so in the second iteration, this is my entering column and I am writing for x2 here. So x2 in the entering column is how much it is? That is a minus 1. So this is the entering column and this is a x2. So x2 value in the entering column, how much it is? That is a minus 1 it is. So that minus 1 we want to write it over here. So we have to multiply this value throughout here like this. And we have to do the operation over here, and we want to write it these values over here, and the same value we want to write it at here. And similarly you have to do the calculation for x3, which I have told it for x2. Now these are the values which I have got it for x2. Now you have to follow the same method for the calculation of s3. Now let me again go for calculating the z equation. Now let me check whether I have got any negative values here. And the calculation for z equation will remain the same for which I have followed for the first and second iteration. So this into this we have to multiply, like this we have to multiply, and you have to write the equation for this. Now you have to calculate and write it. So I will be directly writing the values of z equation over here. So for this I have got a 5.25, this I got a 0, and here also I get a 0, and here it is I got a 2.75. And for this I got a, now here I got a 0 value. Now what, after looking at this z equation values, are all the values are positive here. So that means that we have to stop our iteration now. Since there is no negative value, that means that there is no any entering column variable. So we have to stop our iteration at this point. Now after this, what we need to check here is we have to check the value of x2, x3, s3, whatever the at the last iteration we left out with the variables. So we have to check these values at the RHS side. These are the RHS column here. So x2 value in RHS is how much it is? 4 it is. So note down that value here, x2 is equal to 4. And then what we have is x3 value is 2 here. So x3 value is 2 here. And we don't have a x1 here, so leave about it. So now these values we have to substitute into the objective function. So in the problem, my objective function is given to be x1 plus 2 x2 plus x3. So now we have to substitute these values here. Since we don't have x1, that is 0 will come. 0 into, we have 2 into x2, we have 2 into x2 is 4 here, plus x3 is 2. So after doing this calculation, so I'll get the value of z max as 10. So my z max equation, the z max value is 10, and to achieve this, my x2 value is 4 and x3 value is 2. So this is how we need to use simplex method for the calculation of LPP problem.